Hi everyone, welcome to Lesson 48. 大家好，今天我们学习第48课。Did you want to tell me something? 你想跟我说什么吗？ Okay, first things first, let's look at the keywords and expressions. Dentist. Pull out a tooth. Cotton wool.Collection. Nod. Meanwhile. Remove. As usual, before you look at the flash, I want you to think about these questions.
跟往常一样，在我们看动漫之前，先来看看这几个问题。
Question number one. According to the writer,When do dentists always ask questions?
作者说，牙医们总是在什么时候问问题？
Question number two. What did the writer do in answer to the dentist's questions?
作者做了什么，算作对牙医问题的回答？
Question number three. What did the writer tell him after the dentist at last?Remove the cotton wool from his mouth.
当牙医最终把药棉从他嘴里取出来的时候，作者跟牙医说了什么？
Dentists always ask questions when it is impossible for you to answer. My dentist had just pulled out one of my teeth and had told me to rest for a while. I tried to say something.But my mouth was full of cotton wool. He knew I collected matchboxes and asked me whether my collection was growing. He then asked me how my brother was and whether I liked my new job in London. In answer to these questions, I either nodded or made strange noises. Meanwhile,My tongue was busy searching out the hole where the tooth had been. I suddenly felt very worried, but could not say anything. When the dentist at last removed the cotton wool from my mouth, I was able to tell him that he had pulled out the wrong tooth.
My goodness, what a dentist!
天哪，这是一位什么样的牙医啊？
Alright, let's try to recall some of the details in the lesson while trying to answer those questions.
好，下面呢，我们通过回答问题再来回忆一下课文中的情形。
According to the writer, when do dentists always ask questions?
作者说，牙医总是在什么时候向你提问题？
According to the writer, dentists always ask questions.When it is impossible for you to answer.
作者说，牙医总是在你无法回答问题的时候向你提问题。
What did the writer do in answer to the dentist's questions?
作者做了什么，算作是对牙医问题的回答。
He either nodded or made strange noises, because his mouth was full of cotton wool,After the dentist pulled out one of his teeth.
他呢，要么是点点头，要么是发出一些奇怪的声音，因为他的嘴里塞满了药棉。
What did the writer tell him after the dentist at last removed the cotton wool from his mouth?
当牙医最终把药棉从作者嘴里取出来的时候，作者对牙医说了什么？
The writer told the dentist that he had pulled out the wrong tooth.
作者告诉牙医他拔错了牙。
Alright, that's all for the questions and answers. Now, let's look at the language points. I tried to say something, but my mouth was full of cotton wool.
我想说点什么， 但是我的嘴里塞满了药棉。Try to do something 表示试图做某事，但并不一定能做成。Cotton wool 是不可数名词，所以呢，不能用复数形式。请看下一句。He knew I collected matchboxes and asked me whether my collection was growing. 他知道我收集火柴盒，于是呢，问我，我的收藏品是否在增加。Collection 是收集品的总和，经常是用单数的形式出现。Grow 在这里的意思是增加。He then asked me how my brother was and whether I liked my new job in London. 随后他问我，我的兄弟怎么样，我是否喜欢在伦敦的新工作。这个句子中要注意有两个宾语从句，一个是 how my brother was， 还有一个是 whether I liked my new job in London。请大家注意的是，在宾语从句中的词序问题。这里呢是陈述句的语序 ，How my brother was， 而不是 How was my brother。In answer to these questions, I either nodded or made strange noises。作为对这些问题的回答，我。或者是点点头，或者是发出一些奇怪的声音。In answer to these questions， 意思是作为对这些问题的回答。这里 either or 这个结构表示或者怎么样，或者怎么样，或者是要么怎么样，要么怎么样。请看例句。Either the letter got lost。Or you didn't write to me at all. 在这里 either or 这个结构连接两个分句。这句话的意思是，这封信要么是丢了，要么就是你根本就没有给我写。I will call you either this evening or tomorrow morning. 我会给你打电话。要么是今天晚上，要么是明天早上。You are either with us, or you are not. 这句话的意思是，你要么是跟我们一边的，要么你就不是。Meanwhile, my tongue was busy searching out the hole where the tooth had been. 与此同时，我的舌头正在忙着寻找刚才被拔掉了牙的那个窟窿。这里 meanwhile 意思相当于 at the same time。 Where the tooth had been 是一个定语从句，修饰 the hole。 The tooth 指的是 the tooth that had been pulled out。 Be busy doing something 是英文中的一个习惯表达方法，意思是忙着做某事。 busy 后面要用 ing 的形式。 search out 意思是找出找到。请看例句。 The librarian finally searched out the book I wanted. 图书管理员最后找出了我要的那本书。请看下一句。When the dentist at last removed the cotton wool from my mouth, I was able to tell him that he had pulled out the wrong tooth. Remove something from some place. 从什么地方把什么东西拿走。Remove the cotton wool from my mouth. 也可以换一种说法。那就是 took the cotton wool out of my mouth。 请大家注意，这里 was able to 不能用 could 来替代，因为这里表示的是在某种特殊的情形下能够怎么样。 OK, that's it for the language points. Now let's move on to key structures and usage. 在 key structures and usage 这一部分，我们先来看一看 topic sentence,也就是说一个段落的一个中心句。请大家看看我们这儿的例句。 Dentists always ask questions when it is impossible for you to answer. 这个句子把故事中的大体上的一个情形做了一个说明，所以我们叫它 topic sentence。我们在以前的课文中也学到了很多 topic sentences, 请大家看一下。People are not so honest as they once were. 如今人们已经不像以往那么诚实了。这也是一个 general statement, 是一个表示一个总的情形的这么一个句子。Jasper White,is one of those rare people who believes in ancient myths. Jasper White 是属于那种相信古代神话的少数人之一。这也是那一课课文中的 topic sentence. Aeroplanes are slowly driving me mad. 飞机正在使我慢慢的发疯。那么这也是那个故事中的一个主要的topic sentence. If you park your car in the wrong place, a traffic policeman will soon find it.
假如你把车停错了地方，交通警呢，很快就会发现。这也是那个故事中讲述一个主要情形的一个句子。请大家记住，这种用法就叫 topic sentence。
下面呢，我们还要讲一讲动词 make 和 do 在一些句子中的一些用法，因为这两个词都是英文中最最常用的动词。我们一起来看一下。
He has made progress. 他取得了进步。You never do a job properly.
你没有一件事干得像像样样的。
Why can't you make up your mind?
你为什么不能下决心？
I have to go out now. I must do some shopping.
我得出去了，我得去买点东西。
Do me a favor, will you?
帮我一个忙好吗？
Don't make such a noise.
别发出这样的声音。
You have just made a mistake.
你刚刚犯了一个错误。
He always does his best.
他总是尽他最大的努力。今天我们学的这个故事讲了一个马达哈的一个牙医，是一个心不在焉的牙医。英文中呢，可以说 an absent-minded dentist. Absent-minded 意思是心不在焉的。
And the patient was probably too nervous to realize that the dentist had pulled out a wrong tooth.
故事里的病人呢，可能也是因为太紧张了，以至于都不知道牙医拔错了牙。
Well, why do you think dentists talk to their patients while treating them?
另外，我想问大家一个问题：你认为牙医为什么在治疗病人的时候对他们要讲话？
Well, the reason is probably that they want to divert their attention to make it less painful for patients.
原因之一呢，可能就是大夫想转移病人的注意力，使得这个治疗的过程不那么痛苦。
They want to divert their attention to make it less painful for patients.
Okay, that's it for today's lesson. See you next time. Bye.